Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Battle. The best way to understand a campus placement process for any particular company is to hear the experience from the students who have been actually placed in that company. So we have started a new series wherein our students who have been placed in various companies have come to us to share their experience, and it will help you a lot. So today we have with us three of our students who have placed in Capgemini. And first of all, I would like to congratulate them for their success. They'll be sharing various tips, various experiences which they faced during Capgemini process, and in detail process details about various rounds. So first of all, I would like to welcome them and thank you for giving your time for coming over here and sharing the experiences.
Thank you, sir.
So before we start, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for instant updates regarding various campus placement processes. So let's start. So first, Prachi will brief us about the entire process, and then in detail we'll be discussing each round. So Prachi, share us the entire process, how it was exactly.
Thank you, sir. Okay, hello everyone. So I'm going to tell you about the selection process which is conducted by the Capgemini. So basically there were the four rounds. So first round was the of aptitude test, and once we qualify the aptitude test, the second round was of the pseudocode section. And after qualifying the pseudocode section, the third round was of the technical interview, and the last round was of the HR interview. So this was the complete selection process of the Capgemini.
The eligibility criteria during our process was we need to hold a degree, a BTech degree in any circuit branch, and also we need to have 60% aggregate in 10th, 12th diploma and throughout our graduation. Also there we need, also we should not have any active backlog when we are appearing for the exam, Capgemini test.
Okay.
Talking about the job profile of Capgemini, there are two domains, like infra and non-infra. Infra is all about new technology like cloud computing, its security, its services, etc. And non-infra is all about developing, like Java, C#, website, web development and database design. During our process, the domains which was given to us was decided on the score of a second round, that is pseudocode round.
Now let's discuss each round in detail. Okay, so each one of you can take up any round and discuss in detail or share the in detailed experience about how you faced those particular rounds.
So the first round was online test, which was held on CoCube's platform. So it basically contains of two sections. One was analytical section and the other was written English communication. In analytical section, we had quantitative aptitude, 16 questions on quantitative aptitude and 16 questions on logical reasoning. In those 16 questions, the time given was 40 minutes, and we could switch between the sections. The time was combined time, but the cutoff was sectional cutoff. Like we need to pass in each section to crack the first round. In quantitative aptitude section, the topics were like time work, speed, also percentage, then area and perimeter. Those topics, and in logical reasoning, major were flowcharts, and the one in which we have to guess the next figure based upon the series of figures. Also coding, decoding, one or two questions on blood relation and sitting arrangements. Mm-hmm. Now coming to the written English test, we have to write an essay on basic topics like demonetization or any phrases. So what matters here is your grammar, the punctuation marks, and the content doesn't matter. The weightage is not given much important, because what our HR told us in our pre-placement talk is there's a machine who is checking your essay, and no human is reading each and every line. So how accurately you write it, rather than how heavy vocabulary you are using in the essay, is what matters. And minimum 180 words you need to write in that section. So the time allotted may change, so I prefer that you should check it before going to the appearing for the test, like how much time is allotted for each section. In our time, during our test, for essay writing we were given 20 minutes, and for analytical section we were given 40 minutes.
So did you find that in 40 minutes you had to solve some 32 questions,
yeah,
right? So the time was sufficient?
No. The questions were comparatively easy. Like I was able to solve the question.
Okay.
But because of the time restriction, it was like I couldn't solve each and every question.
Okay.
Just because of time. Also in logical reasoning, there were flowcharts. So the decoding of the flowchart required much time. And the question on that flowchart was only one question.
Okay, so roughly how many questions you attempted from each section?
In logical, I tried
tried to attempt all the questions, but in quantitative, out of 16, I attempted 9 to 10 questions.
Okay.
And rest 6 questions, as there was no negative marking.
Okay.
So I just attempted those questions. I didn't solve it.
So it was mentioned before that there is no negative marking?
Yeah, it was mentioned in the pre-placement talk which we had.
Okay.
So at the first round of the aptitude test and the essay writing, so when you submit the essay, within 5 seconds you will understand that you are qualified for the next round. So the next round was second round was of the Sudoku section. So in the Sudoku section, it is consists of two sections. That is one of basic MCQs, that is of we can say of time complexity, space complexity, which is based on the topic of data structure, C, that of stack, binary tree. And the second section was of the code snippets, that is just like for loop, while loop. That is, we are, for example, we can say that there is some integer value assigned and you have to find what is the respective value of those. And even some questions or the code is having some compiler error. So in those cases, we have to solve that.
How much weightage was given to the MCQ part and the code snippet part?
There was no such criteria. It was just like 50-50% both sections.
Okay, so equal weightage was given to the code snippets and the MCQs. Okay, what was the level of difficulty? Was it very tough or?
Code snippet was quite easy.
Okay.
But the time complexity questions, just like MCQ, that was quite tough about the data structure.
So 20 questions, how much was the time allotted?
30 minutes.
Okay, so was it sufficient?
I didn't found it sufficient time because the first section, which is of complexity, but I found it some difficult, but course snippet was quite easy. So it was okay.
So I like to tell you that the best part of Capgemini is once you have your aptitude test, once you crack it, you are directly eligible for technical route. Pseudocode route is just to check whether you are eligible for infra section or non-infra section. If you crack the pseudocode round, you are eligible for development, that is non-infra section. But unfortunately, if you got some less marks, then you will get infra section, that is cloud or new technologies. So again, talking about the technical interview, panel for two such domains are different. And according to the panel, interview takes place. For development, it's hardly of 5 to 10 minutes, and basically interview goes on your resume, what the points you have mentioned in your resume, like your projects, your paper presentations, or any internships you have done in your curriculum. And for infra, it's all about cloud, its service, how cloud develops, or what is its use. And it depends upon the new technologies what are coming in the market. But according to me, in technical interview for infra section is quite difficult or quite lengthy. Some of my friends' interview were of nearly 45 minutes or at least half an hour. Whereas for non-infra section, it was hardly of 10 minutes. So once you crack technical interview, it's directly HR, where they just check your communication, your confidence, and how dedicated you are to the company. Like, are you ready to relocate, or are you ready to work in the night shifts, etc. Where your family will support you. Such questions are there. So comparatively, HR was quite easy. Once you are prepared well, there is no problem to crack HR round, because it's just about check your communication, your dedication towards company, your confidence level. That's it.
Okay, so we have checked in general what is the exact process, right, from the aptitude test, the essay writing round, the pseudocode round, the technical and the HR interview. We also checked various topics asked in the quantitative aptitude, logical reasoning, some of the essay writing tips. Also, we found out that pseudocode round was a non-elimination round. It was a round during their process, it was a round wherein the domain of the student was decided. After that was the technical interview round. The technical interview for the one domain was a little bit lengthy, and for the other domain it was not that much lengthy. So some of the students faced nearly 30 to 45 minutes of technical interview, but others comparatively faced nearly 10 to 15 minutes. The HR interview was comparatively easy if you are prepared well for the basic interview questions. So now I would like to ask you some more questions, like, since you appeared for TCS prior to your Capgemini drive, so comparatively what do you find, whether TCS was a difficult drive or the Capgemini was a difficult drive?
TCS was
Actually, for Capgemini, I found logical section is quite easy to crack.
Okay.
RT, I found TCS and Capgemini are at same level.
Okay.
And what generally happens, like TCS have a coding section in their aptitude test itself.
Okay.
So some of the students face difficulty in coding section, but in Capgemini, there is no such coding section. You have given code snippets in pseudocode section, but you don't have to actually code the problem statement.
Right.
So, I think it's quite easy to crack Capgemini RT rather than TCS. If you are well prepared for coding, then no doubt you will crack TCS.
One more question I would like to ask is that the elimination. Generally, elimination from each round depends upon either the company's requirement, but since Capgemini is hiring in bulk, so what was the elimination percentage? Means roughly how many students appeared for the aptitude test and how many were eliminated?
It was a full campus in one of the nearby college, and nearly there were 300 students, and from aptitude test only 60 students were selected.
Okay.
But all the 60 students were finally placed.
Most of the students got eliminated from the aptitude test, and those who cleared the aptitude test, they were directly selected after the pseudocode technical interview and HR interview. So I think aptitude test is the main hurdle for cracking Capgemini company. Okay, so in general, what was your aptitude preparation strategy for Capgemini, since it appeared immediately after TCS for your campus, right? So what was your strategy?
So there was no as such strategy, but I started preparing with the basic aptitude topics, like I already mentioned, time, work, percentage, train and everything. Also, as I told you that Capgemini had their online test on CoCubes platform. So I also appeared for some CoCubes tests which were provided to us.
Okay.
So that was it actually, because the time span was also very less. Just got the information about the drive 1 week prior to the drive.
Okay.
So the time was also less. So I preferred more on giving tests rather than on preparation.
Right. So did you practice some previous year questions?
Yeah, I solved many of the mock tests which were present on our platform.
Okay. So, what was your strategy for interview preparation, especially for technical interview and the HR interview preparation?
As far as my communication is concerned, I was good in communication, but for the technical part, I faced a mock interview which was conducted by an industry expert from Messenger in TalentBattle, and it was 1 hour long interview. And after that interview, I got to know what type of questions I will face, or how I should answer. The industry expert also suggested me many more things, the way I should answer. So I got very good suggestions from that industry expert, the way I should present my knowledge, because I was knowing. For one example was when I was explaining my third year project.
Okay.
So I was knowing entirely what my project is, but I wasn't able to convey that. So what I exactly need to speak, the way in which I need to speak was that things I got to know after that mock interview session, which helped me a lot.
So now, since we have checked a lot of information about the exact process, would you like to mention some of your personal experiences or some of the insights which can prove helpful for our audience?
Yes, I observed in my technical interview. Okay. Basically, in technical interview, some of the technical questions are expected. But from the start of my interview, the questions were like, they were checking my level of dedication towards the company. Just like they were asking me about that if you are working in our company for 3 years, and suddenly you are not having any work, so what you will do? So they are checking that if I am loyal with the company. And not this one, they have given me many situations. Been almost 20 minutes in first 20 minutes of my interview, they were asking me that type of questions only. And
okay.
Later they came on the technical part.
Right.
So the questions like if another company will offer you the higher package. Means they were checking me, I'm really want to join their company or not.
Okay.
They were checking my confidence, that is, if I'm not able to tell one answer, then it will affect my next answer.
Okay. Okay, so generally we know that the interaction with the HR in the interview room is very important, but there are many cases wherein the interaction with the HR outside the interview room is also very important, and there was one such experience with Revati which she would like to share.
Okay, so basically we were waiting for our technical interview to come.
Okay.
And we were sitting, and the HR arrived, and he was just trying to make us comfortable, like be confident. He checked our resume, he read the points of the resume. And be confident, the person who is taking technical interview, he is a very senior most person, so within some minutes he would understand that whether you are
willing to learn new things or not, and that is what we are here to check. Apart from your basic knowledge, some basic knowledge, you don't need to be very nervous like what he will ask. He won't go into many complexity. So he was checking on our resume. Also, he asked some of the questions like, he also offered water to us, like be confident, don't panic.
Right.
And also after the interview, like once my interview was done and I was going back to the meeting area, that time also he inquired like, how was your interview, how was your answers, and what do you, whether you asked some questions or not.
Okay.
So these were some things, and which he also again pointed out in HR interview, because I personally was very nervous in HR interview, and he was like, we already interacted before, then you need not to be nervous.
Okay, so as we have checked the entire process of Capgemini, we also heard them about their various experiences, how you need to prepare for various rounds of Capgemini. So I don't think it will be that much difficult for you to crack Capgemini if you are prepared prior, if you have cleared your aptitude concepts well in prior, and if you have faced at least one or two mock interviews, technical and personal mock interviews, and if you have some basic programming knowledge of and coding knowledge. So basically Capgemini focuses more on your learning attitude, your basic aptitude skills, and your communication skills. So students who want to crack Capgemini, make sure you focus on these particular areas. So again, I would like to thank all three of you for coming here and sharing your experience and putting in your valuable time for our viewers. So thank you for watching the video. We'll be again posting in many such videos wherein our students will be sharing experiences about their placement processes. So if you want to know about a particular company, or if you want us to make a video about a particular company, then comment on this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and if you have liked this video, press the like button. Don't forget to press the bell icon, since it will give you instant updates about